Long ago in the heart of England, there was a beautiful castle. It was known to be the finest dwelling in the kingdom.
Today is the ride of a lifetime. Modern Times invites you for a free ride. Tuesday at 9:30 on BBC2.
The big boss with the six-figure salary.
Lambeth can be one of the best and leading authorities in the country.
Gets her hands dirty.
Smells going to be sick.
The whole system in Lambeth is a complete shambles.
Back to the floor, Tuesday at 9 on BBC2.
The weather for the coming week now on BBC Two with Bill Giles.
Hello again. It's still pretty cold across many parts of Europe. You can see through the night time temperatures below freezing right from Spain, right across France, Germany, up into Russia. And I think it's going to stay pretty cold there over the next few nights. By the end of the week, somewhat milder weather beginning to push down across the UK, across northern France, across Holland, Belgium and western parts of Germany. But even by next weekend, still very cold across into Spain and particularly across into Russia as well. In fact, at Moscow, it's seen some very low temperatures. It stayed below freezing since the 8th of November. The lowest daytime temperature was on the 20th when it only rose to minus 15, and the lowest nighttime temperature, minus 18 degrees. And as I said, it looks as though it's going to stay below freezing for this rest of this week. Now, as well as the cold weather, we've seen a lot of heavy thunderstorms down through that central part of the Mediterranean during Sunday, really getting some really nasty ones coming into western part of Greece, all associated with that area of low pressure. And I think that's going to continue with the unsettled weather during Monday and into Tuesday, some of it pushing further north, giving some snow over the Balkans, as you can see. And further to the west, decent weather, some fine weather, are coming back across into Spain, into Portugal. But then more weather fronts edging their way down from the northwest as we go through into the middle of the week. Back into this country then, and we've got this band of rain coming southwards on the forward edge. There's still likely to be some sleet or wet snow, but I think it'll gradually peter out as we go through the rest of the night and into tomorrow morning. A cold night in the southeast, down as low as minus 4 degrees, and a cold night over Scotland, Northern Ireland, northern parts of England. That's where we're seeing some quite dense patches of fog around too. So some advice for you, sleet or wet snow likely tonight, mainly over Lincolnshire, the Midlands, and down across into the high ground in southeastern parts of Wales. Still a lot of cloud in this area tomorrow morning, still some outbreaks of rain, still a bit of sleety snow around. Brighter to the southeast though, good deal of cloud around, but nonetheless brighter. Further to the north, that's where we're likely to see the fog patches, but I think most of them will clear away as we go through Monday. By midday, most of them are gone, and most places getting brighter too, the weather front decaying away, so many places seeing some sunshine, although more rain coming into these northwestern parts during the course of the evening. It's not going to be terribly warm, particularly in the southeast again, but not feeling as raw as Sunday. The winds will be quite a bit lighter. And then into Monday and Tuesday, weather fronts beginning to push their way in from the Atlantic once again. So more rain on Tuesday, pushing its way southeastwards, followed by showery weather. And then this little ridge of high pressure coming in for the middle of the week, keeping it a little bit quieter, but only for a short time. That's it. Bye for now.
BBC One will keep you in the know with BBC News 24 through the night. Meanwhile, here on BBC Two, BBC Learning Zone begins in 15 minutes.
Hello and welcome. This is BBC Learning Zone. The night's programmes get underway in a moment with a sequence of programmes about childcare and child development. And that's after this.
Barely managing to manage, small business a little too small, careering out of control. Let BBC Learning Zone put you back on track and help you steer clear of staff trouble.
Mr. Brittus, why don't you listen to people?
What?
You never hear what people say.
Laura, I had a medical 3 months ago. My hearing is A1.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, you never hear what people say.
Learn from people who've built businesses up out of nothing.
The most satisfying thing right now would be to give all the money back to the bank and say I no longer need you, you know. Store my money and pay me rather than me borrow money and pay him for it, you know.
And follow some high-flying careers. For all your business and training needs, parachute into BBC Learning Zone at 5 a.m. And for a free programme guide, call 0181 746 1111.
We begin tonight with FETV, the series which brings together specially chosen extracts from the BBC archives. Tonight we're exploring the fraught issues of childcare and child development. Over the next 2 hours, we'll be taking a look at the early development of children, including elements such as play and language. Drawing on a range of extracts from education and documentary programmes, we'll be examining the role of carers, with particular reference to coping with accidents and dealing with child discipline.